Hey Fluffy Gamers, are you struggling to optimize Throne and Liberty for your low or mid system? Whether you are grinding PvE or dominating in PvP, I've tested it all to find the best optimal settings for the smoother gameplay. And there is a way to do PvP without filling your CPU with unnecessary data. Let's begin with setting up the settings. In the screen tab, there are two settings worth mentioning. Frame limiter. If your CPU is already running hot, capping your FPS can stabilize performance. Frame limits stop your CPU working harder than it needs to, which can smooth out gameplay, especially for low-end systems. And the frame generators, DLSS and FSR, these can give you extra FPS, but at the cost, they don't improve visuals and make your hardware work harder. On 4-core tests, I was only able to get 15 to 20 extra FPS, but with heavy cost on the system, so leave those for later on. Once we have set up everything else and you feel there is a little more system power left, then you can come back here and play around with those settings. Here is how I recommend setting up your quality tab, depending on your system. First, let's talk about optimized large scale combat. As far as many other players have tested it, it does not seem to have any effect, no visual or performance wise. Just like the next option, shader preloading, that does absolutely nothing. Volumetric fog, set this to high, it removes the fog and adds richer colors to the game. Lighting quality. Low-end systems should use medium, while higher systems can go for a high. Character shadow quality. Add this only if you actually care about it. Level of detail. Keep this on low, it's really heavy on the CPU load. Vegetation quality. 4-core systems could set it to medium, while 6+ cores can handle high. Effect quality. We'll revisit this later at the boss fight. Anisotropic filtering. Low systems should use x8. Higher systems can go up to x16 for sharper distant visuals. Shadow setting. Medium for 4-core CPUs. High for 6+ cores. Shadows are magical FPS boosters in crowded places. Shading quality. Leave this on low to avoid unnecessary strain on CPU. Post-processing, set this to high on all systems, it helps balance excessive lighting. Character count, keep this on high, unless you don't really care about PvP, in which case low gives you much smoother frames. Avoid epic, it's a crash magnet. View distance and screen space reflection, keep both low to avoid CPU stress. Ambient occlusion, medium for low systems, high for better systems. So let's go check out some boss battles. PvE bosses are simpler to handle because of the population density is much lower. Players are divided between three portals, so less players means less strain on your CPU. So let's go check out some conflict bosses, shall we? So here we see players popping in on the edge. I'd say it's pretty good distance.
Oh shit! What happened?
Finally! It's you and me!
What do you mean you and me?
I've been waiting for you!
Where is everyone?
Come here!
Oh, what?
Click on the subscribe! And smash the like button! Like that.
Okay, let's go to another boss then. There are three settings I think we need to talk about. View distance, effect quality and character count. Let's start with the view distance. This setting takes enormous amount of resources, but in PvP it adds no tactical value, so why do some insist using that? I have no idea. Then the effect quality. Some players claim that this affects the visibility of the skill effects at a distance. From my testing, I've found no difference between low and epic. So what skills does it help to see? Please let us know down in the comments. And the last part is character count. For most players, high is the sweet spot. Setting it to epic might cause crashes, especially on lower-end systems. Trust your battle commanders to call out on distant threats while you focus on fighting. So what is the way for PvP to save CPU? In Throne and Liberty, a setting like character quality isn't just visual. It triggers something called physics engine. Look at this NPC with a lantern on the low settings. The lantern stays fixed, but on high it swings realistically. The same applies to other players and their capes, hair, and few more items. It might not seem like much, but in crowded PvP fights with dozens or hundreds of players, every bit of physics calculation adds strain to your CPU. That's why optimizing these settings can make a massive difference. So why am I talking about this? Well, that's because character quality effects behave same like texture quality. Meaning if your player camera gets close enough to objects or players, then these effects are applied no matter what your settings are. So what can you do then? Well, the answer is fairly simple. Play it like top-down mode. And another reason in going to a top-down camera view is to boost your performance by reducing rendering of distant objects like mountains or castles. You not only gain smoother frame rates, but also avoid these forced calculations that can unexpectedly burden your system. I know it's not for everyone, especially when you're used to targeting from closer view, but it's something to keep in mind. If you want to know more about the hidden bottleneck that affects every system in this game, then go check out this video. Stay fluffy. Bye bye bye.